Syphilis is a sexually transmitted infection, STI, caused by a type of bacteria known as Treponema pallidum. In 2016, more than 88,000 cases of syphilis were reported in the United States. The rate of women with syphilis has been declining in the United States, but the rate among men has been rising. The first sign of syphilis is a small, painless sore. It can appear on the sexual organs, rectum, or inside the mouth. This sore is called a chancre. Syphilis can be challenging to diagnose. Someone can have it without showing any symptoms for years. However, the earlier syphilis is discovered, the better. Syphilis is only spread through direct contact with syphilitic chancres. It can't be transmitted by sharing a toilet with another person, wearing another person's clothing, or using another person's eating utensils. The four stages of syphilis are primary, secondary, latent, and tertiary. Syphilis is most infectious in the first two stages. When syphilis is in the hidden, or latent stage, the disease remains active but often with no symptoms. Tertiary syphilis is the most destructive to health. The primary stage of syphilis occurs about 3 to 4 weeks after a person contracts the bacteria. It begins with a small, round sore called a chancre. A chancre is painless, but it's highly infectious. This sore may appear wherever the bacteria entered the body, such as on the mouth, genitals, or rectum. On average, the sore shows up around 3 weeks after infection, but it can take between 10 and 90 days to appear. The sore remains for anywhere between 2 to 6 weeks. Skin rashes and a sore throat may develop during the second stage of syphilis. The rash won't itch and is usually found on the palms and soles, but it may occur anywhere on the body. Other symptoms of secondary syphilis may include headaches, swollen lymph nodes, fatigue, fever, weight loss, hair loss, aching joints. These symptoms will go away whether or not treatment is received. However, without treatment, a person still has syphilis. Secondary syphilis is often mistaken for another condition. The latent, or hidden, stage of syphilis is the third stage. The primary and secondary symptoms disappear, and there won't be any noticeable symptoms at this stage. However, the bacteria remain in the body. This stage could last for years before progressing to tertiary syphilis. The last stage of infection is tertiary syphilis. According to the Mayo Clinic, approximately 15-30% of people who don't receive treatment for syphilis will enter this stage. Tertiary syphilis can occur years or decades after the initial infection. Tertiary syphilis can be life-threatening. Some other potential outcomes of tertiary syphilis include blindness, deafness, mental illness, memory loss, destruction of soft tissue and bone, neurological disorders such as stroke or meningitis, heart disease, neurosyphilis, which is an infection of the brain or spinal cord. If you think you might have syphilis, go to your doctor as soon as possible. They'll take a blood sample to run tests, and they'll also conduct a thorough physical examination. If a sore is present, your doctor may take a sample from the sore to determine if the syphilis bacteria are present. If your doctor suspects that you're having nervous system problems because of tertiary syphilis, you may need a lumbar puncture or spinal tap. During this procedure, spinal fluid is collected so that your doctor can test for syphilis bacteria. Primary and secondary syphilis are easy to treat with a penicillin injection. Penicillin is one of the most widely used antibiotics and is usually effective in treating syphilis. People who are allergic to penicillin will likely be treated with a different antibiotic, such as doxycycline, azithromycin, and ceftriaxone. If you have neurosyphilis, you'll get daily doses of penicillin intravenously. During treatment, make sure to avoid sexual contact until all sores on your body are healed. The best way to prevent syphilis is to practice safe sex. Syphilis can also be transmitted through shared needles. Avoid sharing needles if using injected drugs. Mothers infected with syphilis are at risk for miscarriages, stillbirths, or premature births. There's also a risk that a mother with syphilis will pass the disease on to her fetus. This is known as congenital syphilis. Congenital syphilis can be life-threatening. Babies born with congenital syphilis can also have the following: deformities, developmental delays, seizures, rashes, fever, swollen liver or spleen, anemia, jaundice, infectious sores. If a baby has congenital syphilis and it isn't detected, the baby can develop late-stage syphilis. This can cause damage to their bones, teeth, eyes, ears, brain. People with syphilis have a significantly increased chance of contracting HIV. The sores the disease causes make it easier for HIV to enter the body. Thanks for watching. If you liked the video, please support us by subscribing to our channel.